I'm here with Tim, you with Evan Jager. I'm here with Evan Jager from Team USA. He's one of the most popular athletes here in London. Everybody knows you. Everybody mentions your name. Why do you think that is? Why are you so popular here?
I really don't know. I mean, I made the final, so maybe people just recognize me from being on TV or something. I'm really not sure. Maybe it's the hair. It's pretty distinct, so I get a lot of people I probably recognize me just because I look a little bit different.
So Evan, tell me about what you compete in here in the Olympics.
I run the 3,000 meter steeplechase. It's 7.5 laps around the track, a bunch of jumping, hurdling, and water jumping. So
that sounds like a very tough, very challenging. It's not just run 100 meters and you're done. So how do you become good at that?
A lot of practice with hurdling, a lot of flexibility work, going over the hurdles a lot of times, 2-3 times a week, and then just training my butt off, basically, yeah.
Even in a computer game, I run into the hurdles. I can't imagine in real life. How do you avoid running into, because you go at extremely high speed.
Yeah.
And
yeah, you just basically, you always got to be keeping an eye out for where the hurdles, you got to make sure you know when they're coming up, and you got to find your footing leading up to the hurdles to make sure you know which foot is coming up, so you know which leg to lead with over the hurdles. So you're running hard, but you're always kind of focused on where everything is around you. So,
as you know, in the United States, we love basketball, baseball, football. At what age did you know you're a prodigy in running? I mean, because it's not popular. It should be.
Yeah.
But it's one of those things where, like, they discovered you all of a sudden. Like.
Yeah, I started running in seventh grade, and immediately had some success. And right from then, like, I knew all I wanted to do was run for a living, if that would be a possibility. So that was a dream of mine when I was a kid, and making it work now. So
what's it like really to be here, being the teammates of Michael Phelps, of Kobe Bryant? Like, did it sink in, or you're like, wait, this is not real?
No, yeah, it's been awesome. I actually had the opportunity to meet both of those guys, talked with both of them very shortly. But yeah, it's been awesome. That was one thing I was not really thinking about coming to the Olympics. I was really focused on my race and how I was going to compete. And that was just kind of an added bonus, being able to be around such elite athletes in the other sports. So it was really cool.
So what does it mean to you to represent the red, white, and blue, to represent America?
It's awesome. I mean, this is the greatest thing you can do as an athlete, is represent your country at the Olympics. It's the biggest stage there is out there for us. So it's been a treat. It's been so much fun, and I'm so proud to have the opportunity to be able to do this.
If you could compete in something else here in the Olympics, what would it be? What do you think you'd be good at?
You know, I really have no clue. I don't know if I would be that good at anything else. I grew up playing soccer when I was a kid, so I always dreamed of being a professional soccer player before I took up running, so probably soccer.
That'd be awesome. Tomorrow, Team USA women against Japan in the finals for the gold.
Yeah.
Break that game down for us.
It's a it's going to be an action-packed game. The last game, Alex Morgan scoring that goal with just a couple seconds left was absolutely intense. And if it's anything like that game, it's going to be just absolutely wild, because the gold medal is on the line now. So it's going to be crazy.
Where are you from in the States?
I grew up outside of Chicago, and I train in Portland, Oregon now.
Okay, so you're all over the place.
Yeah.
But there's a boxer named Floyd Mayweather. What do you think about Floyd, the money team?
I don't really pay attention to boxing that much. I probably would if him and Manny...
if they got in and settled the score.
Yeah, exactly. That would be huge. So it'd be really cool to see that fight. Two huge, huge names, great boxers. It'd be really cool to see them fight.
Well, I hope you're right, and I hope it comes to fruition, because that's one fight the entire planet wants to see. So there you have it. Stay tuned for more right here in London for ESNEWSReporting.com. I'm Ali Sekbek reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Sekbek. And the Twitter, if people want to follow you?
Evan Jager.
There you have it.